Well, good morning, guys. Welcome to my channel. And you join me here at St. Leonard's. Why are you here? Well, I'll tell you why. This is where I practice the organ, so if I flip the parent light on, that brings the lights on over there. And this main switch is here. Let's put a torch on. There you go. Hang on. The organ blower. There you go. Whoops. Don't know what that was. A piece of paper or something. Hang on. I don't know what it was. It probably that. Probably that. Falling open, I don't know why. Well, we close this, now we go over to the console. Why that fell open, I have no idea. Genuinely have no idea why that fell open. Right, there's... you can see how bright my hand is now. Here's the organ console. And it's on started state of the organ. And here is the face of the organ. I just need to get back and down, because this is... They're just the diapason pipes. But yeah, there you go, some of the biggest, right there. And if you look up closely, you can see up inside the organ as well. See some more pipes there. And we come around here, you see one of the wooden ranks there. But, right, I'm going to put you... Right, here's the console. So, lift the lid. Hang on, I've got to do this one hand. Quietly as well. Right, there we go. Three manuals. Don't know how many ranks, but I'm in the middle of the stop list anyways. So that's good. So here's where we start the organ. Wait for it. There you go. And it's a Rushworth&Dreaper organ rebuilt in 1965. But yeah, it's a gorgeous instrument. Now you're going to have to excuse me while I change my shoes. So I'll put you there and I'll pause you there. Right then. Here are the console. What? This piston. Watch that. I've pulled this out here. The pedal and piston. So if I hit this piston, it'll bring some stops out of the pedal. Like that. Or I do this. Okay, cool. Right, you got it. But I'll take you through each division slowly and steadily. Start off with the swell. And this is under expression, which is down here. Light on again. There's the swell expression there. That's the choir. So we start out with one of the choirs is the Lübschgedacht. I'll show you what I mean. It's virtually inaudible. And yet I'll open the swell up for you. Yeah, I better do this with my hand. Lübschgedacht. There you go, I don't know how you pronounce that, the Geigen diapason? Something like that, another 8-footer. Echo viol. Or viol or what have you. Yep, quietest of the stops. Those three together would be. Okay, 3/8-foots, and you got the voix celeste. I always play that here. Then you got the octave of the 8 down there, this one. A mixture of 3 ranks, I don't know what it would be. I just realised I'm not holding the camera straight. Cool. Right, 16-foot reed. Sounds brilliant on the pedal, this one. A cornopean, which is a trumpet, basically. An oboe. Uh, And then these are just the couplers. You got the swell units off. Don't know what that does. Someone explain to me, please. And then swell octave and sub-octave. I'll show you what I mean. But if I pull out a decent swell. So what?
Yeah, goodbye. Doesn't matter. Bye-bye. Likewise.
Oh, Pete, someone I met earlier, and we were talking about the organ. But yes, the swell can be improved with those, with these two here. I'll turn the light off for you now. So there you go, these can improve it, the octave and the sub-octave. So here we go. And if I had these two.
Oops.
Ciphered. I don't know why. Oh well. Yeah. And I've got a tremulant, so I'll use the voix celeste. I use these four down here, plus a tremulant. Pretty fast, but I'm not bothered. Pedal division, light on. Down here. So, starting with this, right, so again, you've got the swell to pedal, so I'll show you what a full swell sounds like on the pedal. Self-explanatory, really, beautiful. But now we get into the meat and bone. You got a bass flute, 8 foot stop. Got a warden. Don't know if it's picking that up. You got an open wood. Again, self-explanatory, and the octave, I think, for the board. And then you got two of my favourites. You got the third two harmonic. Harmony bass. Right, I've got to be really quiet for this. It's buried in there somewhere. And then you've got my favourite. Can't see that very well. That is the Offie Clyde. And bring them all together. And you get something like. You can add the swell, what I had on the swell earlier, then you get this. Right, light off again. So, with that in mind, I'll just pause and I'll show you the grate and everything. Alright, so we're coming over here now to the choir and the grate, yeah? So we've got a whole flute. Here on the grate, don't know, ask me why that came out, that was like that already. But here you go, you got the whole flute. Alright, good so far. Then you got the viol d'orchest. What another good start. Did I mention that the choir was under expression as well? I'll show you that with the Dulciana. Pull that back in. It's quite quiet, actually. Yeah, and then what's got next? Concert flute, 4 foot stop. The clarinet. Mm-hmm. Then you've got the sub-octave and octave, so I'll use these four stops here. Okay, and then one of my favourites, the tromba. Bloody loud. And then the tremulant again. And now we get onto the great. So we have contrageigen, 16 foot. An open diapason. Pretty much stock on everything. These pipes are uncovered, as all organists will know. A clarabella, which is my favourite. Then you've got an octave to the diapason. Walled flute. Probably an octave to the clarabella. And then you got the 15th, which is a 2 foot. Mixture of three ranks. And the tromba. So yeah, that's basically this organ in a nutshell. I mean, you've got these buttons here called pistons. Like, watch the choir. I'll hit this piston here. It'll bring the whole flute out. Let's pull that sleeve back on, and we've got to bring out the clarinet, and then the tromba. Pretty good so far. Now with this stop here, the pedal and great pistons, I can pull this out like this. Watch. I'll show you. There you go. I could pull them out, but it will pull them out on the stop on the pedal as well. So I've got the octave, the board, and the open wood there. So I can. But yeah, this is where I have to show you. This is where I show you the true power of this instrument. If I pull everything out here. Okay, I've got the swell to the choir and what have you. This is best demonstrated with the swell. So I've got my selection on the swell there. Okay, so it's there. But these stops here. You've got the swell to great, which will couple it from here to here. Swell to choir, which will couple it from there, top to bottom. And the swell to pedal, which couples it from there. Yeah, I'll show you. Explanatory enough. Then you've got the great to pedal and the choir to pedal, so you can pull everything onto it. But it doesn't just stop there. Oh, no. Because I can pull everything else. So if I just take them off, I've just got the great to pedal, so this is all the great sounds that are on the pedal. I'll do the same for the choir. And I'll pull on the tromba as well. Yeah, the tromba doesn't exactly sound great on the pedal. Oh well. Put you back in. But yeah, I'll play some for you now. So let me stop again and I shall show you later. I shall show you in a minute. Right, final clip of the video now. I'm hoping I get it right. I've practiced it all this time. I'm gonna play for you One Eye Just in the Glory to play your lines.